Hello everyone, hope you are doing well. I am Akshay Parmar, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in ITST department. Welcome back to the video tutorial series of the Internet of the Things. Right? Here, today we are going to discuss about application of IoT. Right? And here we have taken one domain, the driver assistant application and the collision detection application in the automobile industry. Right? So first of all, we will see the driver assistant application. Right? So nowadays, the companies are focusing more about safety and precautions, right? So for that we are having driver assistant application. With the help of the IoT we can build that, right? So majority of the vehicle manufacturing companies are trying to make a vehicle more comfortable and safe for their passenger, right? So if they are providing this kind of comfortness and easiness and safety, right, so they can attract more number of the passenger, right, and it will give that more revenue to its company also, right? They are investing more into the research and development. They are experimenting to a design a system that could monitor and alert the user suffering from highway hypnosis or white line fever, as well as they need an IoT based system to prevent an accident caused by an drowsiness of the driver, right? As well as they need an IoT based solution or system to prevent an accident caused by a drowsy driver, right? So for that they have built an IoT application, right? So let's see the importance of this particular application, right? So the driver's drowsiness is one of the major factor is reported into the road accident, right? The majority of the road accidents are happened because of the carelessness of the driver or the drowsiness of the driver, right? So if the driver is not sleep for the so many hours, right, so it is obvious that it is having a drowsy eyes, right? So because of that, it is the major cause of a road accident, right? So drowsiness is a kind of sleeping sensation which can lead to the closing eyes. So what do you mean by the drowsiness, right? So drowsiness is a kind of sleeping sensation, right? So which is the kind of sleeping sensation which can lead to closing the eyes of the driver, right? And the drowsiness makes one physically inactive and insensitive to surroundings, right? So because of that they are not focusing on the driving, and because of that they lead to the accident, right? So we need to monitor the driver's consciousness along with his acceleration pattern and the steering angle, right? So with the help of that we can get to know that this driver is active or not, right? If he or she has really nice command on the car or not, right? So with the help of this kind of application we can keep an eye on driver's consciousness, right? So with the help of that we can keep an eye on driver's activeness, right? If any deviation is detected, right, so in the term of the drowsiness or its something kind of thing, right, so we can detect that thing, right? A system should be there to be alert a driver, right? If we found a drowsy driver, they can buzz an alarm or something kind of thing, right? A process of detecting the deviation and the drowsiness of the driver should be developed, right? So for that we are developing this kind of application, right? So process of the detecting the deviation and the drowsiness of the driver should be developed, right? So for that which kind of sensor that we can use and how we can develop that kind of systems, right? So using an image processing and the machine learning ML technology, we can develop this kind of system, right? This system is detecting whether the driver has a deviation, or that system is detecting that whether the driver has deviated or not, right? By monitoring the driver's facial movements, right? So with the help of the driver's facial movement, we can get to know that the driver is deviated or not, right? After that, we can calculate the EAR, the eye aspect ratio, right? So with the help of that, we can conclude about the drowsiness, right? After that, we can monitor the pattern of the acceleration that driver is having, and at the end, the angle of the steering, we can keep an eye on all of them, and we can get to know that if the driver is deviated or not, right? So with the help of the machine learning and the image processing, we can build such kind of application, right? So here it is clear about which kind of technology we can use for building this application, right? So let's see some of the requirement, the hardware or the sensory requirement for building this IoT setup, right? So the first one is a sensor is there, right? So we can use an ultrasonic sensors kind of thing, right? So with the help of that, we can build this kind of application. After that, the cameras and the onboard diagnosis access, we can have that particular thing, right? After that, for the controlling, we can use a Raspberry Pi and kind of microcontroller to transferring the data and to process the data and take a real time action. We need a really nice connectivity, right? So for that, we can have a WAN connectivity for that. After that, we can use the cloud services for maintaining its data and for the processing purpose also, right? And for the monitoring system or do the analysis, we can have PC or the screen, or we can sense that data, or we can monitor the data with the help of the mobile, tablet or the PC or laptop kind of thing, right? So for the monitoring and the analysis data, we can have that kind of the gadgets with that, right? Right, so that is the basic requirement for building an IoT center for this driver assistant application, right? So let's see the architecture, right? So let's see the basic architecture for these kind of application, right? So further, for that, first of all, we can detect and drowsiness detection system, right? So for that, we are having a camera, right? So with the help of the image processing, we can detect and drowsiness for that particular driver, right? So for that, we are having a camera units, as well as we are having an OBD, right? So what do you mean by that OBD? The onboard diagnosis unit that is familiar with, it is known as an OBD there, right? So with the help of that camera, we can calculate that EAR value, right? So eyes aspect ratio, we can calculate with the help of the camera. After that, we can keep an eye on the facial expression and the lens detection, right? So with the help of the camera, we can monitor the facial expression of that particular driver, right? So with the help of the facial expression and the EAR, we can alert that particular driver, right? If we found a drowsy driver. After that, with the help of this particular camera, we can detect a line, right? So with the help of that, we can make a driverless car also, right? With the help of that OBD, we can keep an eye on the speed variation, as well as we can keep an eye on the steering angle. We can integrate both the data and we can do some kind of processing, right? We can connect that particular camera unit with the help of the USB, and we can connect that OBD, the speed variation and the steering kind of thing, with the help of the Bluetooth also, right? It can be wired as well and it can be wireless as well, right? We need to give that data to the vehicle computer, right? That vehicle computer will take an appropriate action with respect to that received data. If we found a deviated driver, then we can use some kind of alert system, right? It will alert the driver, right? If we found a deviated driver, then the alert system will alert the driver about, please keep an eye on the road, right? After that, the ultrasonic sensors node, right? This is finding the distance between the two objects, right? If any particular vehicle is nearer to some another object, right? Then we can, with the help of that ultrasonic sensors, we can keep an eye on that, what is the safe distance and kind of thing, right? We can connect this particular ultrasonic sound sensor with the help of the wired or the wireless communication, right? After processing all of that data, right, we can store the data onto the cloud, as well as we can, after processing the data, we can get a command from that particular cloud services, right? So for that, we need a really nice internet connectivity, or we need a really nice gateway, right? So with the help of that, we can deploy our data from local system or vehicle's local system to the cloud services, right? With the help of that internet, the vehicle owner can get all the information regarding the same with the help of that particular cloud services, right? After that, if we want to do some kind of research or analysis kind of thing and want to make a decision based on our previous data, then we can give that data to the data analytics tool, right? With the help of the data analytics tool, we can do the research and we can make an appropriate decision with respect to our data, right? So that is the basic architecture that we are following for driver assistant application with the help of the IoT, right? So let's see how it works, right? So first of all, the camera unit is there, right? So camera unit should be placed on onboard for capturing the face of the driver and the road view, right? So with the help of that particular thing, with the help of that particular camera placed at that particular place, we can detect the face of the driver, right? After that camera unit should have an USB connectivity with an vehicle computer, right? And the camera unit sends data to the vehicle computer, right? So it is sensing the so many data, right? For an example, if it is placed on the OBD, then it is sensing that facial expression of the driver, right? And if it is embedded in the front of that car or front of the vehicle, right? So at that time it is monitoring that road view, right? After that, the ultrasonic sensor nodes should be placed at the various placed on the outside of the vehicle for detecting the surrounding the distance, right? With the help of that, all the sensor nodes should be have wired or the Bluetooth connectivity with the vehicle computer, right? With the help of this kind of connectivity, we can transfer our sense data to the vehicle computer, and then with the help of that, we can take an appropriate action with respect to that, right? After that, the OBD unit is there, right? Onboard diagnostic unit, right? The OBD units of the vehicle should be having Bluetooth connectivity with a vehicle computer. So you are running that vehicle computer so many times, right? So what are the major tasks which is performed by the vehicle computer, right? It is collecting the data from the camera units, OBD units, and all of the sensors node, and applying it. And after collecting all the sense data, it is applying some of the business logics, right? And after applying some of the business logic, it is doing the analysis on the collected data on it, and as per the requirement, and send the filter limited data to the cloud computer as well as, right, if required, right? After that, after doing this kind of analysis and all that thing, we are taking some of the precautionary steps, such as sending an alert message for the driver if we found the driver is deviated or it is having a drowsy eyes, right? So that's how we can alert the driver. The vehicle computer should have an internet connectivity for the cloud communication. For yes, it is obvious, really nice internet connectivity for transferring the data from our local system to the our cloud system, right? So let's see, you have one question arise, how this is system is detecting the drowsy eyes for that particular driver, right? So let's see how it's work, right? So first of all, the driver side's camera captures the driver's facial and the eye movements, right? Here you can observe that we have an different point on the eye, right? So P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, and all are the points are there, right? So with the help of that, we can detect the driver has a drowsy eyes or not, right? The camera sends then captured image to the vehicle computer for the ER value and the other calculation, right? So what do you mean by that eye aspect ratio, right? Eye aspect ratio is measured by the following equation. The EAR is equal to P2 minus P6 plus P3 minus P5 divided by 2 into P1 minus P4, right? So that's how you can find out the EAR value, right? So the P2 minus P6 is a distance between that point P2 and the P3, P6, right? Distance P3 minus P5 bar means the distance between that two points, right? So that's how we can measure the distance between them. Using this image processing, the systems find that eye position and calculate the above mentioned distance with the 6 point is there, right? When the driver is closes his eye, right, the EAR value is eventually dropped to the zero and the system is detecting the drowsy eyes, right? So yes, you can observe that P2 minus P6, right? If we are having both the points at the same point, the P2 is equal to P6 is there, right? So zero plus P3 minus P5 is there, right? So that 4 points are merged together, right? So P2 minus P6 and P3 minus P5 both are zero, right? And the P1 minus P4, that value is not changed, right? But because of that particular 2-4 values, P2, P6, P3 and P5, we are getting zero there, right? So that's how the driver assistant application is working with the help of the image processing, right? The roadside camera captures the front image view of the images, right? The captured image is sent to the vehicle computer for detecting the lane, detecting the object which is coming toward its particular road or the way. After that, we can sense that signboards, right? The deviation is monitored using an OBD. The onboard diagnostics device, right? So that's how it is working. After that, the OBD can record a pattern of acceleration and steering angle during the drowsiness of the driver. They compare the recorded value with the threshold value and the historical data for actual deviation, right? All the calculated data is sent to the data analytics and obtain a result is used to alert the driver, right? The cloud data also useful for the vehicle owners. So that's how we can make a driver assistant application, right? If we found a drowsy driver or deviated driver, then we can alert that particular driver, right? After that, let's see the another application of an IoT in the automobile industry, right? So let's see the collision impact detection using the IoT, right? So with the help of the IoT, we can build these kind of application too, right? So modern vehicle are equipped with a collision detection mechanism, right? It blew up the airbags when the accident occur and it is saving the life in the major of cases, right? But if the collision is massive, then the airbags may not be sufficient. Remember that thing, right? In this cases, the emergency is help needed to save the lives, right? In this cases, the emergency help needed to save the lives. So we need a system that measures the severity impact of the collision and the send alert message, right? The alert message contains the location of the accident, right? It is having an severity impact of that particular system, right? After that, we can measure the fire status, the speed of the vehicle, the number of the passenger, the time of the incident war, and all kind of data we can get with the help of the message, right? After that, we are broadcasting the message to all of the authorities like ambulance service, hospitals, highway patrolling teams, the fire brigade, policies, and family members of that vehicle owner, right? So we can send that message to all of that particular stakeholder which is connected with that particular car and car owner, right? So if that single accident is occurred along the highway, then it can be managed without a data of severity of the collision. When the multiple accident occurs on the highway, then the severity data is very important to save life for the very critical victims or the very serious victim, right? So based on the data and the severity impact, all of the emergency help will be reached timely at the point, right? Thus, we need an IoT based system that sends the necessary parameter of the collision. So that is a basic requirement or basic importance for that particular system, right? So let's see the basic requirement for an IoT application. The sensor is the foremost thing which is required for any IoT application, right? So here we are using so many sensors like the FSR sensor, the fire sensor, GPS sensor, camera sensor, OBS sensor, and all kind of thing, right? After that, for the controlling purpose, we need a Raspberry Pi there, right? After the for the transfer the data really nicely, we need a WAN connectivity and the cloud services, right? And for the monitoring and the analysis purpose, we can use PC, tablet, laptop, or anything for our particular system. For the monitoring and the analysis purpose, we can use PC, tablet, laptop, smart device, screen, or anything, right? So with the help of that, we can use that thing. After that, let's see the architecture of the collision impact detection using an IoT based application, right? So here we are using two units, the camera units and the OBD as well, right? So with the help of that camera, we can keep and count on the passenger. With the help of that FSR sensor node, we can keep an eye on the severity impact, right? And at the end, the OBD is keeping eye on the speed and this kind of things, right? All that data is connected with the vehicle computer. So with the help of that USB, we are connecting the camera with the vehicle computer. With the help of the wire and Bluetooth technology, we are connecting the OBD and the FSR technology, right? After that, for the GPS kind of thing, we can use a GPS sensor also, right? Which is connected into the wired manner, right? After that, the fire sensor is also there, right? So with the help of that wire or the Bluetooth technology, we can connect that sensor with the vehicle computer, right? Within a vehicle for the local analysis and the processing, we need that kind of thing, right? After that, after sensing the data and processing the data, we can transfer or deploy our data onto the cloud, right? So we can use a cloud services, right? That with the help of that particular cloud services, we can get an emergency help services which is providing by the provider, right? So therefore that we need a really nice internet connectivity. After that, the vehicle owner family, right? So with the help of the internet, we can store that data too, right? And at the end, we are having a data analytics tool, right? So with the help of that research and the decision making, we can do these kind of thing. The examples are the ambulance, hospitals, highway, patrolling, fire brigade, and the police, and well, so many things are left there, right? So force sensitive resistor, the FSR sensor is used for measuring the pressure applied on the vehicle during that collision. Force sensitive resistor, FSR sensor, is used for to measure the pressure applied on the vehicle during that collision, right? So the FSR sensor are monitor on the vehicle at the place where the impact probability is higher than the other part of the vehicle during the accident, right? So based on that FSR data, we can estimate the severity of that collision, right? The fire sensor and the GPS should be placed at the appropriate place of the vehicle. All the sensor nodes should have a wired or the Bluetooth connectivity with the vehicle computer, right? And the camera unit should be placed on board for the capturing all of the passengers, right? So that's how we can use this kind of application, right? After that, the camera unit should have an USB connectivity with a vehicle computer, right? The camera unit sends and captures image to the vehicle computer, and the OBD units of the vehicle should have a Bluetooth connectivity with a vehicle computer, right? The vehicle computer is collecting the data from the camera units, OBD units, and the sensor node, right? After collecting all the data, is applying some kind of business logic, right? So do analysis on the collected data as per your requirement, right? And after that, it is sending that analyzed data to the cloud for the storage purpose and the processing purpose also, right? Using an OBD, the onboard diagnostics, right, device that system record the speed of that vehicle, right? The fire sensor and the GPS are also used to sense the data to the vehicle computer. Based on that analyzed data and the severity of that collision to the cloud system, sending an alert message to all the emergencies, help services provider and family member for their vehicle ownership, right? The cloud data is used for the data analytics, and it is used to provide a priority based emergency services, right? The system is automatically activated when the collision is detected, right? So that's how that collision detection system is building. So in this session, we have seen that how an automobile industry is changed with the help of the IoT, right? So that's all for today's session. Thank you for the watching.